So in this video, I want to do a deep dive through the new PlayStation 5 user experience. We got a lot to talk about. We're starting off right from the point where you gotta press the PlayStation button to get things started, which we're gonna do right here. When we do that, your controller will connect and you'll be brought to the login screen here. And obviously you can add a new user profile if you want to, log right into your specific profile. You have options that you can choose to log in as online, busy, or appear offline, depending upon what setting you want to choose there. You see a little plus icon, that means you're obviously a PlayStation Plus member or subscriber, which I am. And I have there, and you have down here where you can have the power button to turn right off or enter the different powered modes, which is shit again. Rest mode, turn off PS5, or restart. But we're gonna go ahead and log in here. And we're brought to the brand new fancy interface. It's a real nice, very fluid, has a nice flow to it. I almost want to call this the PS Flow interface. You go from left to right, and up top here, everything's kind of broken down between games. In media is where sort of all your streaming apps are. And we'll go between both of these and kind of explain what's in each one of them. But I want to start off here on the main section here in the main menu in games. One of the first apps that you'll see here is a PlayStation Store app. So this is where you're going to be able to buy all your games and add-ons and digital downloads will all come through here. And if you go down here, you see things are sectioned off between must see, what's hot, coming soon, the games that are coming out real soon. And you'll see little icons there at the bottom, like 10% off. That means if you're a Plus subscriber, you get that off, get a percentage off of that, things that are just announced. And if you hit X into any of these, you can add it to your wish list. You can follow it to get the latest news on it. If you hit this three button here, it'll give you health, ratings, privacy terms. There's more to those options as we go along, depending upon the game and whatnot. And you can see different media about it, and it'll give you some more gaming legal info, more deep dive information here about it right here at the bottom too. So if you want to read more, you can pop it up just by hitting X. Give you a little bit of a bigger screen. But backing back onto that, and you can go all the way down here, it breaks your games down, and like you have all PS5 games right here, PS4 games, pretty much mostly, I think all the PS4 games work and available, except for like a few of them. You have free to play games, so if you're interested in some games that you can just download immediately, play a little bit later, something like me, look at Brawlhalla, Walking Dead. I've actually been interested in playing this because I've been seeing one of my friends, Remy, from Level 1. Check out his YouTube channel. He's been playing this a lot. I'm thinking about grabbing this up. So let's say I want to grab this game. I just tap download. We'll add it to the downloads list and it'll queue it up and it'll begin to download. I got pretty fast internet, so it'll go through that pretty quickly. And you can also see here, you can see what broadcasts are trending between Twitch and on YouTube. You can see the little different add-ons you can add on with it here that are a part of the game. My phone also went off at the same time because I have the PlayStation app installed too, and unless it notifies you when new games have been installed. And if we hit this three button here and we hit view product, it kind of brings us to the sort of the hub page that gives you all the media, all the legal info, same info that we kind of saw before here with it. Go ahead and back out. We'll back out here one more time. All right. And if you hit the option button once again, you get view to game. We hit wish list if you want to add that game to wish list real quickly. You can go over here to sort by all different titles and genres if you want to, release dates, whatever you want to sort and filter by. Hit the circle button to back out again. If you hit L and R, you go through collections. You know, you have the indie section. It'll put all the independent games that are right here, things like Fall Guys. Subscriptions will all be right here, the PS Plus collection, which we'll dive in a little bit deeper into because that's really cool to have, especially with the PS5, some of the games that you get with that. You have browse right here, which just brings up all the games. You can see it right there. You can search for games specifically. So you can either type your search in, and you have to between all, which shirts, apps, games, media, players, different people you want to search for. If you have all games, movies, TV shows. And since the PS5 has a microphone built into it, you can actually search by voice as well too. Tap on it. You have to do the privacy notice with that if you want to. You can speak it to the microphone. Let's do Call of Duty. Gonna bring up everything related to Call of Duty right there in front of you, which is pretty cool. It's still listening to me. Let's bring that back. Oh yeah, there it goes. All right, pretty cool. But you kind of get the idea there, how you can search for things with your voice there, your wish list. You have your cart right there with all your games in it. Hit more here. You can do your payment methods, subscriptions, transactions, your purchase settings, all the personalized settings. We can look at that a little bit later in a different section here. But that's basically the PlayStation Store. That's where you're going to be getting most of your games from. Now, if we go back up here to the top, we go to Explore. The Explore page is basically where you're gonna get your latest news. Now, if you double tap the PS button at any point, it'll bring you quick official news, which basically is some quick stuff that's similar to what you see in Explore, and you can tap on those to read about it, or just go right into the Explore page and it'll kind of go through all the stuff that's there. So there's live broadcasting, popular videos near you. This is sort of the community tab effectively, and sort of what's going on in the world of PlayStation and the world of gaming here. You can see the little updates. If you tap on any of them, it'll start to play that and it'll give you more information, or just basically play that video. But that's Explore. And if we head back out here again, so this is the game I just recently downloaded, and if I want to jump into it and play, I just hit play. It'll start to bring up the game, play. Load things up here. Bring up the splash screen. Lastly, as that's going, we're going to hit back right out of this, hitting the PlayStation button, and then we'll hit the home button right here to head right back out, back into home. We have Astro's Playroom. And what's pretty cool is that when you can see the interface here, it looks very similar to basically the sales page or the purchase page you see there. You have the play option. You can also see a progress right here on the right, what type of game it is, the full game, it's free. You have these little activities here, kind of tells you what's going on in terms of trophies and other little things you can do. What's really cool here is that, let's say I want to replay a portion of this, and I've noticed this specifically in PS5 games. Let's say I want to do the teraflop treetops again, and I hit resume, I just hit the square button. It'll jump right into that portion of the game no matter where I am total in the game total. So as you'll see here, boom, loads right back up into this particular section. I can go back here and play it again if I want to. Start that up again. It's actually the pretty cool motion capture one. I'm not going to go through the whole thing, but you kind of get the idea. You can hop up and whatnot, but we'll do that a little bit later in a different video. But I'll go ahead and hit the PlayStation button. And now while we're in this, this is another sort of UI to be definitely familiar with. This is basically in-game canceling, in-game stuff that you can do. So you can jump around and do exactly what I did before in different parts of the game you want to jump back into. You also have your trophies that show up as well too. News, video clips, all those sort of things that have been created. You can go back down here at the bottom. You have home, you have your switcher. Now the switcher is interesting. It'll allow you to switch between games, but it's not gonna sort of quick resume that you've seen similar on the on the Xbox, where it has that quick resume feature. Now the game's gonna reload. So if I go back to Brawlhalla, I can hit play, go to Game Hub. If I hit that, goes to there. If I hit the PlayStation button again, and I wanna switch back to Astro's Playroom, it's gonna most likely refresh that game all the way back to as if you were first turning it on. See, right there. So it doesn't have the quick resume, but it allows you to switch between games pretty quickly. You have a notification section here. Pretty simple. I think that's self-explanatory. You can set up Do Not Disturb if you want to, the pop-ups. You have your game base here. All right, and then you have music, so you can play any music stuff you've connected to Spotify, but it's pretty interesting when you sort of do that and listen to our play now. There's some interesting stuff with that, because if you have HDCP turned off, which I do to be able to record my my screen captures, actual media content won't play, which I'll show you that in a minute. You have your sound here, so you can adjust your sound to control the speaker if you want to turn that down a little bit, turn it back up. Your output, if I'm connected to my TV, but if you're connected to a VC or a sound system, you can adjust that information there too. Media, music and volume, and music and video, how that volume works. Voice chat, if I had a headset, that would show up there. This is your mic here, and you can control which mic you're using between the wireless controller. It's on the DualSense controller. You can mute it. There's also a physical button to mute it as well, too. You can adjust your mic levels, which brings you into here. And you can see here, I have the controller probably at arm's length from me right now. And you can see it picks up pretty well across the board here with that. It's pretty nice. Go ahead and hit back here. Go back into the PlayStation menu here. You have the wireless controller options. You can turn off and go deeply into controller settings. It brings you quickly into that. Hit the PlayStation button one more time. Go back here. This is where you can check out your profile, online status, your trophies, whatnot. And then this is the power. It gives you all the power settings right there. So you can pretty much get everything while you're in game without having to go back home and be able to control everything. And it's the same thing if you hit the share button. The share button works anywhere within the PlayStation interface for the most part. And this is where you can quickly take a screenshot. You can save your recent gameplay. We talked about this a little bit in our video when we talked about sort of being able to record content with the built-in capture card and external capture card. So definitely check out that video for a little more details on that. You can start a new recording here, but basically differences between here, this works with the default 1 hour that it saves of gameplay in 1080p automatically while you're playing. And this starts a brand new recording as if you're starting it for the first time. You have your broadcast settings right here, your capture options here, which we went over in a different video. So definitely check that video out, which I was talking about earlier. If you want to have HDR, you can toggle these all as you want to between 1080p, 4K, HDR, include your mic audio, party audio, whatnot. And if you go over here, this is the quickest way to get to your gallery. You can see your most recent created clips, and you can hit L and R, L1 and R1, go between all different videos, photos, snapshots. You can go to edit them, you can favorite them, delete them, go to media gallery, you can jump right in, and you get everything right there. And it takes a screenshot of or a video of every trophy that you earn. And you can have favorites, you have your trophies there, albums, and whatnot. And you can also go down here on the left side here. You can sort by date, by media, whichever one you want to do, video clips, screenshots. You also have the ability to multiple choose. So if you want to select all, select multiple to either share or delete, whichever one you want to do here. You can kind of do that. I think you only select one for sharing, but you can delete, move, or actually down here, the three dots. Let you to copy to a USB drive you have unplugged in. You can copy that content over if you want to. But that's the media gallery. Okay, so let's take a little bit deeper look into these different games here. So as you see, I'm scrolling across. You obviously get a sort of a background splash page of it. Some music will play of that as well too, depending on that game. And this will sort of rotate along as you play different games. Different things will come up, different things you download. This will whole section right here will adjust. Now, if you hit the menu button on the icon up there, you can check for updates on the game. You can manage your game content. Basically, that's things like, and in this case here, you can download different language packs if you want to, and different data with that. So there's little sort of tweaks and things that kind of come into there. Any extras will show up in here that you can download and add on to the game. If we go back into that section here, you'll see you can delete the game, more information, intellectual property, game version. You can see now the cool thing is if you pay for a PS5 game that also has a PS4 game, it gives you the option of both, and you can choose which one you want to have and which one you want to download. Obviously with the PS5, I want the PS5 version, but the PS4 version might be something you want to use if, let's say, you have a PS4 or you want to save on storage space as well too, because the game is probably a little bit smaller. All right, if you go to information, if you go inside of here, this gives you sort of the parental controls, the last update, the size of the game, the download status, the version, starting the app, installed and console storage, all that information readily available for you with quick access. That's pretty much how you can do that there. So down here, when you're in the game, you can just play if you want to play right away. You can mod the suit. I mean, sorry, not mod the suit. This is activities and sort of trophies that you can earn, things like that, official news, trending broadcasts, kind of get the idea. If you hit the three dots here, this is where you can view the product, which brings you to basically the game's hub itself, which you can follow and unfollow. You'll see there on the left side, the right side, you'll see that you can see who are, what other friends are playing, when it was released, what's the minimum storage amount that you're going to need. You can see I can jump to the Ultimate Edition if I want to and learn more about it, or if I want to grab that, I believe it'll let me upgrade to it. You can go back to the standard edition version if I want to here too. We'll just back up and we'll actually go up here into the game library where all your games are located. So any games that you have, PS4, PS5 will show up in here. You have your collection, games that are installed, PlayStation Plus games, which these are all games that you can download if you with your PS Plus subscription that are part of the PS collection. It's pretty cool. Like games like God of War are on here. Uncharted 4, Ratchet and Clank, Last of Us, really cool to have that. PlayStation Now, which we'll do a little bit of a deeper dive into once we set that up. It's pretty cool that you have that here. That's a streaming service, but you have that available here. We'll actually go back into here. What I want to go is to a game. I want to go to Final Fantasy. So let's go into here. And let's say I go into, let's go back into View Product here. You see what's installed. You have the different add-ons, and you can add the different add-ons here as you want to. So let's say I want to grab this, hit download, and it'll download that add-on immediately. and you can also do the upgrade right here. That's what I wanted to show you mainly, is a digital upgrade is available right here. And it's usually in the add-on section of most of the games. So if you want to upgrade the game to the digital deluxe version, or maybe to the PS4 to PS5 upgrade, you can do that all right there, easily and simple. So you can see how fluid it is, and you can see how easy this UI is, where everything's like right there in front of you and very easy to find. You can see my progress here, how many trophies I've earned, what trophies that I've earned, what broadcasts. It's all kind of the same sort of flow. I really like how everything just flows well together. Nothing really feels out of place. You can also sort your games right here on the side. Let me go back up here, and you can take another look here. You can look at, we actually went through that already. But that's basically the basics within this particular section and how sort of things look in the game section. Now in media, very similar. If you sign into different applications, you'll have that sort of splash page to bring all the information up here to you. But here's the thing about this, because I'm using a capture card, I don't believe, yeah, it's going to pop in. It says can't start the game or app, turn off settings, system, HDMI enable, HDCP. So it needs that content protection encryption turned on before it's going to play any of your music and stuff like that. It's weird because that doesn't happen on the Xbox, but here, unfortunately, that it does. So I would need to not have my capture card plugged in if I wanted to use the media applications. I'm hoping they find a way to sort of change and get around this and find some different way to go about doing this, because that's really kind of annoying to have to disconnect and reconnect and do all this stuff with your capture card all the time to be able to do that. I understand as a built-in one, but you get more options when you want to use an external one. So I would have liked to seen them kind of figure something out with this here. But this is where all your apps, Disney Plus, you can see all the apps that are available, Peacock, Plex, all available right here. And if you want an app, let's say Plex, hit download. And it'll download the app, and you get a little notification there at the top. And download and install. Oh, it's already ready to use. This will probably, see, this one will probably block me too. Yep, it'll block me the same way. But you kind of get the idea with the application section. Now we have top here, we have search, which just brings you back to universal search that we saw before. And you can either type in or use the voice commands to search for content. We have our settings, which we'll dive deep into just a moment. I want to get into that a little bit later. I want to go into our profile section here a little bit. This is where you can adjust your online status. You go deep into your profile, you can see what the trophies are. If you hit that, brings you to all the trophies that you won between PS4, PS5, and they'll tell you the little indicators, PS Vita. I forgot to even earn those, but they are there. Head back. You can switch users here. Now let's dive deeper into the profile. This is where you can get an overview. Pretty much everything you have, your trophies earned, your games, your friends that are online. You tap on any of these, kind of brings up the list right there in front of you. I go right here to games, friends, you go into shared, any sort of shared content that you've done, some streams, all that stuff will show up right here, available to you. Now you can adjust your online status up here. You can edit your profile. You can edit your privacy settings as well too, which dives into this section here. You can view and customize how all that works right within here, who you communicate with, what activity you share, what friend suggestions you get. You can make all those adjustments right here. If we go into edit profile, you can edit your name, your online ID, your profile picture. So if you want to change from an avatar to a different profile picture, you can. You want to edit your name, you can do that as well too. You can put that on your online gamer tag if you want to change that. I believe you get one free change with that when you sign in. Now you can sign in with the PlayStation app, which I did during the unboxing. You can just kind of do a quick push to the app and it'll let you in. But we'll back out of that. Actually go back and edit profile. You can change what avatar you're using. I don't think I've actually selected one. You got premium, action, adventure. Let's go with Mass Spider-Man here. I'll add that. Cover image, you can add this to your profile. So we can go ahead and select an image. Let's just select one from a recent screenshot that I took. Let's see here, media gallery, all favorites. Oh, I don't have any selected, all right. Let's pick one from here, from somewhere. I'll probably pick a random one. Let's just choose this one here. Hit select. And you can kind of zoom in where you want it to kind of be. Hit rotate. You can get it right the way you want. Hit save. Wait a few seconds here. And now that should show up in the background of your main profile. So that's how your online profile will look towards others. You have that there. All right, you go to about, you can type more information about yourself if you want to here, and you can say what languages you speak outside of my primary English for me. If you have other languages, you can add them right there. So that's setting up your profile, your online status, privacy settings. That's pretty much it in the terms of the profile situation. Now let's jump into settings where we can dive deep into this. So the first part of this is user guide, health and safety, and basically the paperwork you would normally get, they just kind of put inside of here. You can just quickly hit and it'll pull it up and you can kind of read that if you need to go through it. You have your text size, bold text, high contrast. You can go like this, change your text around, make it very large if you need to, large, smaller, all depends on what you're looking for. I'm actually going to put that back to normal. You have high contrast, auto scrolling speeds. You can reduce motion to help with people that maybe get some motion sickness. I get that from time to time on certain games. You can enable a screen reader. You can adjust the controllers and have different settings between vibration intensity, trigger effect intensity. You have closed captions. You can add that on. You can turn that on to display it. Chat transcripts. You can enable that. You can choose the different languages and the voice type. If you want to do that, it's pretty cool to have that stuff. Go into our network here. Pretty simple. You can work on your connection status between wired, wireless, see if your PlayStation network is signed in. You can do sort of different things here with that, and you can test your internet connection if you want to. You have your settings here. You can go ahead to set up your internet between wired and wireless. You can't have them both on at the same time. So you can have either one connected or the other one connected, but they won't be connected at the same time. It'll always use another one by default. Users and accounts, which we kind of went through a little bit here. You can see your sign-in ID, security options, edit your profile, payments and subscriptions, your address, communication preferences, and choose your gender if you want to display that on here as well. You can set your privacy settings, which I showed a little bit over earlier before here, with what you can do here. How your data is collected, how people interact with you, you can change all that. You can link your other services here, Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, Spotify. You have other, you can console sharing and offline play, restore your license, you can sign out of your system. You have your login settings, you can log in automatically or set up a passcode. And this is where you can manage all your users. You can add, delete users as you want to. We'll head back out. Family and parental controls right here. So if you want to have more control over what if you, your kids are playing, what the family's playing, how you want to manage things, this is where you would set up a default code. You set up your code to restrict things. You can set up family management, which I believe you actually have to set up through the app. So you can set all that up if you want to within there, which is nice. I'm not going to go too deep into that because I don't really have a use for that currently. We go into system. This is where you can check on your console information, your system software and updates. You can report system errors, error history. This is where you can start your data transfer, which I believe if you watch our other video on how we transfer data from PS4 to PS5, you saw how that worked. You can backup restore data from an external USB drive. You can do reset options, which will this is basically wipe the PS5, if you want to go through that particular part. This is the HDMI, which when I talked about with setting up your capture cards, you have to have this turned off for it to work. But at the same time, if you have that turned off, you can't use media applications currently with that. I'm really hoping Sony does something to change that soon to make this a lot easier to deal with. You have your language options here between your console language and input language. Your date and time settings you can set up right here and the format you want them to be in. This is remote play. I don't know if you checked out our recent video as well talking about remote play, how to set it up, especially the PS5 remote play app on the PS4 to play from that console. You have to enable this within here to do that. You can look at your connection history, link device just in case you're not signed in on your PSN account on both of them. You'll need that code from there to do that. You have your power saving options built in within it in here as well too, how you want it to enter rest mode, set times, features available in rest mode, so you can do a little bit deeper, enable turning up PS5 from Spotify, which is pretty cool. I'm actually going to enable that. Supply power to USB ports for a period of time. You can set time until console turns off, until controller turns off. You can have a different timing with that, and you can have different timing for rest mode. There we go. We have web browsers, which allows you to use the web browser. I think they're going to have a separate app for that, but it's probably for different things that run in the back end when it comes to the apps for that particular thing. So that system, let's take a look at storage. So within storage, this is where you can check out all your games and apps, media, save data, other. So by default, the console says it has 825 gigabytes on the box. You get about 667 of that Sony, you need to allow us to use to upgrade that storage as soon as possible because this is just too small. But here you can see your games and apps, and you can manage these as you want to. So if you have God of War, you want to delete it, which I never would, you can delete the game there. You can select deselect, you can select all and sort of manage that. And we'll get back to that in a second because it stops the game. You can have usage date, name, size, and in terms of what you sweat it by. Your media gallery just brings you to the gallery where you can manage this. Go ahead and hit back. Here's your game save data, and it separates between PS5 games and your PS4 games here. And you can select and deselect and delete whatever you want to do right there. And other is just going to pop up and say this reserves this for system data, needed for games and apps to work properly, your operating system, whatnot. You lose about 100 gigs, so that's something to keep in mind. Down here, if you have external storage installed, you'll be able to use that and extend the storage, play games, do whatever you want to do with that. You'll be able to manage that right here in this section if you have that connected. I just actually unplugged that because I was transferring some data from that. Go down to sound. You can control your microphone on the controller. Yeah, you can adjust the levels, which you saw us do earlier. Your microphone status when logged in is on. You can change that to mute. You can change when you start chat or broadcasting, how you want with that. Your audio output, you can make the adjustments here. You can make all the different things. If you have headphones, you can enable 3D audio, adjust 3D profiles, different music options here. You can adjust your audio formats between if you need to use Bitstream Dolby or Bitstream BTS. Linear PCM should be fine for most people, especially with HDMI. Then you can just control your volumes here, volume levels right here as well too. So that's sound. Screen and video, you can see your video output, you can see all the information, you can see the current resolution, color format, HDCP is turned on or off, HDR, what frequencies that are being using for HDR and non-HDR, all right there for you. So it's a pretty cool page just to kind of get a good summary of everything that you have working right now. You can change and adjust your resolution if you want to, the 4K transfer rate, if you're seeing some flickering or having some issues, you can make that adjustment. You can turn on HDR on and off automatically, you can adjust your HDR, which sort of goes through a whole menu of that. You can adjust deep color output, RGB range. You can adjust this as well too on both of these. You have your screen, you can adjust the display area if it's not fitting out the whole way. And if you want the screen to sort of dim, you can check the timing on when that's gonna be to don't dim, 5, 15, or 30 minutes. You have the Blu-rays right here, and you can turn on Blu-ray Live if you want to allow the Blu-ray to connect to it to do that. I have the standard edition, not the digital edition, so this is only really going to be an option if you have the Blu-ray DVD drive version of the PS5. All right, accessories is where you control all your Bluetooth accessories. You can have your wired controller, you can add more to it, turn off accessories, turn off Bluetooth if you want to. You can manage your controllers here. The communication methods, the trigger effect intensity, brightness control indicators, the volume. If you get the media remote, you can set it up here. If you get a keyboard, you can set your keyboard up here, mouse up here, and the camera. If you decide to get the HD and the PlayStation camera right here, you can make adjustments to that. Save data, game and app data. So this allows you to actually do some pretty cool stuff. So this is your PS5 that you can see what's on your console storage, and you can upload it to cloud storage if you want to. You can see what's on cloud storage. I don't really have anything up there yet. You can sync your save data as well to auto-synced, and you can view the sync status. So if you want your game saves to stay within the PSN Plus cloud, which you need to have the PSN Plus service to be able to use, or get the most amount of storage to be able to use it properly, you can use that. You can do the same thing with PS4 stuff. You can do your game presets, so you want certain default game difficulty from your games, how you want first person view. You can do the adjustments to the camera. Game default, normal, inverted. You can have these all set up automatically for you by default as soon as you play the game. As soon as you install the game for the first time, it'll have these already set up for you, subtitles and audio. You can have that already by default, so when you jump into the new game, all these settings that you like or preferred are right there for you. You have automatic updates. You can control how these work. Pretty self-explanatory. Spoiler warnings if you want to have that set up. Game status, so you can sync with the PlayStation Network, you know, whatever games, trophies, whatnot, it syncs with everyone else, so your friends and people on the PSN network can see what you're doing. Notifications, pretty self-explanatory. You can allow pop-ups, previews, display time. You can change how long it stays up, when friends go online, from games. You can adjust all these as you want to with all different sort of toggles and options. that you want during video, during broadcast, during games, however you want these things to sort of work, you can make the adjustments right here for your notifications and do whatever you want to do with them. Now, captures and broadcasts, which we went over a little bit in our capture card video that we did for the PS5. So we went over some of these settings sort of already between screenshot formats, video clip formats, broadcast quality. Talk about that. You can go all the way up to 1080p 60 if you want to broadcast at that. You can do your audio, include voice chat, camera settings, which I don't have my camera plugged in, overlays that you want, chat to speech, trophies if you want your trophy video saved, trophy screenshots, trophy video durations, whatever you want those to be, can be set right there. And that's pretty much it for the settings page in terms of the deep dive with that. And that's pretty much everything we have here in terms of the PS5's menu. I know we went into a pretty deep dive with that. If there's anything specific that you want us to sort of go over here a little bit in a little deeper detail, a little bit of a different video that you want me to talk about, let me know in the comments below. I'm definitely willing to do a deeper dive if it makes sense to be able to do so. I'm hoping that we get some customization, because right now you can't customize anything in terms of themes and things like that, which I had a lot of fun with doing on the PS4. I have to imagine that down the road we'll be able to do custom themes on that a little bit more here with it. That's something that's definitely got to happen. Overall, I really like this interface. Nice, fluid flow. I know it's just called PS5 User Experience, a place of your experience, but PS Flow is what I really feel that it should be named. Let me know what you guys think about this. Definitely, for sure. Questions, comments, concerns, post them below. Also, be sure to check out all of our other PS5. I keep confusing the names here. PS5 stuff here. Definitely talking about transferring data over, because that's very important. If you saw, if you see an original unboxing and setup, definitely check that out. We have some gameplay in there with that. And also definitely check out Remote Play. It's pretty cool. It gets more use out of your PS4 and being able to connect to your PS5 remotely from anywhere you're already sending a connection to play some PS5 games. It's pretty cool as well. Definitely check all that stuff out. And thanks for watching.